The tools in Photoshop are designed to do a particular thing, but sometimes we can use them in an unintended way to get really good results. Let's use this photo of a bride for an example. It's too bright everywhere and nothing's really popping. The background's bright, her dress is bright. It's all kind of just clashing with each other. So how would you go about fixing this? Would you be using things like shadow highlight? Let me show you an unexpected way to do this. What we're going to do is go under the layers, and in order to fix this, we're actually going to use black and white. So the black and white filter was originally designed to convert color photos to black and white, but this has a hidden use where we can take the areas based on those colors and make them lighter or darker. Watch this. With the black and white on, what we're going to do is we're going to go under the blending modes. So one we're going to use is luminosity, and we can immediately see things are starting to look a little bit better, and that's because some of these have been adjusted. So the luminosity blending mode will only adjust the bright and dark values, and it won't change the color. So if you watch this, like maybe we want to make her skin just a little bit darker so it's not so blown out, we can pull it back. Notice this, we can target just the red area, but instead of changing the colors, it's changing the tones in that area. Let's do the same thing with the greens. Maybe we want to darken these down, go much more cinematic. And we can do the same thing with the yellows. And notice as we do this, we can really just kind of add some pop between her and the background. And if we look at this, there's the before and there's the after. And of course, I'm just using this as an example. There's a lot of different things you could use this for. But there's an additional way that we can use this as well. And that's to grab this little finger tool. And then this will enable us to just click and drag, and notice now it's changing the yellows. So it's actually going to find the colors underneath your cursor, and it's going to enable you to change those to, you know, make those adjustments. And if you look at this, everything's all just kind of blown out, and there now the bride is really popping. And if you are worried about the colors kind of shifting a little bit too much into the darker kind of areas, which is kind of cinematic, we can also fix that though. We'll create another adjustment layer on top. And we're going to grab the hue saturation. But what we're going to do with the hue saturation is we only want to select the green region. So let's grab this little finger here. Let's go into that green region and click. And then when we do, notice it's selecting this area. And when I say green, believe it or not, it's actually a lot of yellow in there as well. But now when we're in here, we can shift the hues. Look at this. If we want to shift it more into a more pleasant kind of a yellow, maybe give it a little bit more saturation. You know, we can do all of that right there. So this gives us that additional adjustment to kind of maybe bring in some more just kind of warm and pleasant colors. So we look at this before and after. So drop a comment and let me know if you learned anything new in this tutorial. And if you're new to the cafe, welcome. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.